Now, he tested mice with cancer.
That's right.
Talk to us about that. What happened?
Well, before he treated people, he thought, well, it seems to be working. It worked on himself. He described at one point he was in Scandinavia, the middle of a Scandinavian winter, and he was tanned, as though he'd been in the tropics. And he said, I felt so healthy. So he knew he was onto something. But as a doctor, you can't. It's dangerous to start to practice on people until you've got evidence. So he then obtained mice with cancerous strains within them. And he treated them in small accumulators and found that the tumours disintegrated.
This is extraordinary stuff, Peter, isn't it?
So it's still there today if anybody wants to do that.
He started shouting from the rooftops about
this.
That's
right, yeah.
I mean, you would, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
So he starts to say, hey, look, I'm discovering this is an extraordinary thing I'm looking at here. What happens then?
Well, he had trained 20 doctors who were working mostly in
GPs,
mostly in the New York area, and some of them would begin to introduce it to the hospitals.
Because these guys, they were the proof, weren't
they? That's right.
These guys went, this is incredible what you're doing there.
They studied with Reich and they realised the truth of what he...
And like you said, he wanted to put it in the hospital.
That's right.
I should shut up, carry on, this is great.
No, well, so what happened was, eventually, the authorities got jealous. There was a woman columnist, Mildred Brady, and she wrote a very scurrilous article about
Mildred Brady.
Brady.
What did she write for? For which
I can't remember the magazine.
Yeah, but one of the big newspapers.
It was also her articles were reprinted in various magazines, and that started the campaign against Reich. Eventually, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration interfered and brought an injunction forbidding Reich to continue. Eventually there was a trial, he was found guilty, his work was demeaned as worthless, but...
Peter, can I stop you there? Yeah. So the FDA didn't say, Dr. Reich, we're hearing some, you know, weird and wonderful stories about the orgone energy accumulator, show us how it works. There was none of that.
No, no.
Let's not have a trial or anything.
That's right.
Let's not try. What do they call them? Not trials. You know, trials. Let's not medically trial the
thing. It was like a witch hunt.
Exactly.
Now, what happened was, Reich described how there was FDA men around the, and snooping around, and you know, and eventually, the order came. The injunction was to destroy all his equipment and to burn his books.
And he didn't have a lawyer that was in any way able to
The lawyer was scared.
Yeah.
I mean, I didn't meet the lawyer, but I mean, for all the reports.
Yeah, you were living this, and you were following this at the time.
That's right.
Because you'd imagine a good lawyer would, and I can understand the lawyer being nervous about it, but a good lawyer, it's a frustrating thing, going to, I don't know, the Supreme Court in whichever relevant Supreme Court it was, New York, Boston, wherever, or the Supreme Court of the United States. But they didn't.
Yeah, but how do you do that? I mean, look, to jump the gun, who's representing Edward Snowden?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
It goes on all the time. I found this, if you counter the official status quo, you've got a tough job.
Peter, do you believe, I mean, I've read all this stuff, and too many people, since we first met you and I, too many people have said to me that, oh, you know, all the evidence is there that this guy had discovered something truly remarkable.
Exactly, yeah.
And you believe in your heart of hearts that he did.
Well, what
and
I...
He was,
listen, yeah. I'm just a jazz musician.
You're just a jazz musician.
And?
No such thing as just a jazz musician.
Right. And what happened was, if I started to talk to people about it, they say, how do you know?
Yeah.
So I had to start experimenting myself so I could say yay or nay.
That was my next question.
Okay.
People trying to reconstruct the orgone energy accumulator.
And they're simple.
And you're, is it really?
Yeah. And then, so then I found perhaps more than I'd bargained for. you know. Not only was Rush correct, because I had repeated the experiments, I couldn't argue with what he found, but I also found ramifications from that which was not in Rush's literature. So in a sense, I'd seen beyond.
But he had, but because of course he was stopped, wasn't he? To remember that.
They jailed him.
And then he died in prison.
He died 2 weeks before he was due for parole.
Of a heart attack.
Well, that's what they said. Who knows? I mean, what can you believe? That's the official thing.
And all his research material was burned.
Well, the research stuff was destroyed. 8,000 books were burned.
Peter, did any of these 20 doctors, did any of these men and women say, hang on a second, you know?
Yeah, but what could they do?
Yeah.
Unless they put... Michael Silbert put his head on the line. He was also jailed. Simeon Tropp, who I had the good fortune to meet and to know quite well before he died, and I still am still in touch with his family. He knew, what could he actually do? You know something, but how are you going to get it across? Look, I'm 85. I've learned a lot, and I've learned things, and I'm not afraid to say it, beyond the pale. But who listens? And if I...
Oh, we're listening.
Yeah, I know, but
we're listening.
What will happen to me, you know, if I say too much?
And Peter, you've set it up, and I know because you told me before, and you've followed the experiments as any, you know, as anybody I suppose could do, with a mind to do it and the means to do it, and you say that he was right, and there's more beyond what he found.
Before we come to the end of our interview, can I just add something?
You can add whatever you want.
Yeah, eat, drink, and be merry, for tomorrow we run out of oil. That's the core of it. But what the thing is, we're all hooked on this idea of energy without understanding what energy is. Energy is not just the power of steam. Nuclear energy, so-called, is just heat energy with all terrible radiation. The heat is used to create steam with power. We think of energy in terms of chemistry. We have to learn to see it in an entirely different way. It's to do with electromagnetism, but more importantly, it's resonance. And that's where Tesla realized there's been a lot of realization about that. When we take our eye off of the oil that we're destroying and ruining the earth and look at electromagnetism and resonance, we won't need the kind of energy that we have today.
Is it one of the great tragedies, Peter, that he was locked up and all these materials were burned? I mean, it must be one of the 20th century's greatest tragedies.
Yes, I think so, yeah. Yeah, yeah, I see it that way.
Give us a look. I want to show off the book. This is the book, is it?
No, this is
a different book.
This is not.
We'll give this a plug as well.
Yeah.
Well, tell us about this then, go on.
I haven't read it all yet. The book is called An Inordinate Fondness for Beatles. And it's about Wallace, who was really the pioneer. Darwin's gotten the credit, but Wallace is the one who actually did the work. Darwin only went out there once. And Wallace lived it and was the one who really added to our knowledge.
Can we finish just briefly on Reich, and we'll definitely have you back again, you know that, we'll have you back again, we'll get into
okay.
We'll get into different things. I mean it's such an unbelievable story. I mean, you wrote about it in your book about him.
Yeah.
But I mean it's made for a dramatization, isn't it? It's made for
to
put some actors and put some money together.
Well,
and make this.
We did one when we've got it on disc. At the Cockpit Theatre a couple of years ago, I wrote a script for it, and Peter Marinka and another actor and myself, and we went through the whole history of it in an hour and a half, and some music, and Simeon Tropp's son played piano. I mean, you've got to see this sometime.
Yeah.
And maybe that can awaken people too, you know.
Peter, it was an enormous pleasure to speak to you again. It's such a fascinating subject.
I want you to mention the writer of this book, because we talked about it.
Which one is this?
This, the one that I just talked about.
Well, can you pronounce it? I think it's Polish or...
It's a Polish name.
Russian name, is it?
Polish, well,
good luck at that one. Go on, I'll have a go at it.
Yeah, okay.
It's Paul Spencer Sokoszewski.
That's right.
Gets in.
Yeah.
And it's an inordinate fondness for being...
And he's around, and this book is just published.
Well, good morning. Peter.
Yeah.
Pleasure. Thanks for coming.
Thank you. Really enjoy seeing you.
Yeah. Okay. That's the brilliant Peter Ind. To be continued is right. The brilliant Peter Ind. Don't forget, coming up after the break, we've a look at the headlines with David Icke. Lauren Murray to come later on as well, and much more back after these.